Now that you've learned about some of the tools and processes you can use for configuring and monitoring performance, let's take a look at some scenarios. I think many of our viewers might have experienced something like the following. Let's say I get a call at 2 a.m. that there's some performance issues with my SQL database or managed instance. Now, Bob, you've taken just a few support calls in your time here at Microsoft. Can you walk me through, what should I do?
Right, Anna. Certainly, over my years in support, I have seen performance issues come to my attention from customers and something that they often struggle with. And over the years, we kind of had this philosophy: is a problem in SQL Server running or waiting? You just saw in a previous demo video something like a running type scenario. And so I want to just keep in mind to the audience here, it's just SQL Server Engine in the background. So that same philosophy is going to apply. And let me just kind of walk you through how I would walk through a problem if I was tackling a performance problem with Azure SQL. So first of all, I'm going to be looking at resource consumption. And I showed in a demo video how to use DMDB resource stats to do that. Server resource stats could be used for MI. You could even be using the Azure portal and Azure Monitor to look at that. So you first want to see what does resource consumption actually look like? And you could even use alerts through Azure Monitor as well to be alerted to a resource consumption problem. Well, let's say you look at it and it's CPU, just like we saw in a previous demonstration video. This is what I call the running scenario. And typically, the problems that come down to customers in running scenarios is an executing query or a compiling query. Compiling queries have a unique characteristic. You can see things like set statistics time to find out is a query compiling, or even through the query store, you can see that. But for executing queries, what do? Well, you use the things you've always used. You use query store, DM exec requests. You look for an actual wait type called SOS scheduler yield. In fact, that's an interesting scenario, right? You're waiting but running. So the reason it's called a waiting scenario is because you don't have enough CPU resources to schedule your work on your SQL server. Same thing applies here to Azure SQL. You can look at query stats or procedure stats to drill in to estimated plan information about that query. This is going to look very familiar to you. Same type of process you might use for a SQL server as you're doing with Azure SQL. What about a waiting scenario? This is going to be very much the same as you're looking for a SQL Server scenario. But keep this in mind, you set up and deploy your Azure SQL with the appropriate tier and deployment option that in some cases have limits, things on IO or memory or various other things that could affect these types of waits. So keep that in mind as you're looking at IO waits or latch waits or different types of waits in your environment. Even things like planned cache eviction can be affected by the memory limits of your Azure SQL deployment. Well, how are you going to look at that? You're going to use query store or look at these DMVs. DMOS wait stats, one of the most popular DMVs in the history of SQL Server, is still applicable both to managed instance and Azure SQL database. For exec requests, just like we saw in a demonstration video, you're going to see what is the wait type of the query that is taking either the most resource usage or that is blocking the world, like my blocking chain. Yes, blocking problems are the same in Azure SQL as they exist in SQL Server. Now, there's some specific Azure scenarios I wanted you to keep in mind of that are there because of the way we deploy things inside the Azure infrastructure. So first of all, we do not allow you to have unlimited access to the transaction log from a performance perspective. So you might see a wait type called log rate governor show up. This is us, as you're building transaction logs through different operations you're doing, as we're building up log records, we decide whether we need to throttle the amount of log you're generating to make sure we meet those SLAs for you. So you might see this wait type show up. And in fact, you're going to see that before you see a common write log wait show up. And other types of governor waits can show up as well, depending on the deployment, whether you have a pool, Azure managed instance, or even hyperscale. Now, worker limits are interesting. You're used to seeing, in case of SQL Server, thread pool waits to kind of indicate maybe you don't have enough worker threads or it could be a block scenario. And that type of scenario potentially can show up in a managed instance. But for Azure SQL database, we put a cap on the concurrent worker limit before you'd even reach those numbers. In fact, you can't even configure max worker threads. So you might find an error in those scenarios because you reach what we call a concurrent worker limit. And to overcome that, you would need to change your vCore or service tier to get more concurrent workers. Now, for business critical scenarios, you can see sometimes the popular HADR wait types like sync commit, flow control, and throttle log rate send receive.
Bob, why are we seeing all these waits?
Yeah, it's interesting you asked that, Anna, because people are looking at the screen going, well, duh, I mean, if you've got an availability group, these are normal waits to see as part of running a sync availability group. Keep in mind that a business critical deployment is indeed behind the scenes using always on availability groups. So I've seen customers go from general purpose to business critical because of their performance needs. All of a sudden they see these wait types show up and go, I didn't build an availability group. Why am I seeing these? And Anna, the reason is that we're building one behind the scenes. So I want to make sure and call out that these waits are not surprising and not specific to Azure, but something you may not recognize or be aware of that could show up because we're using availability groups behind the scenes. Now, Anna, in addition, for hyperscale, there are a few special waits that might show up because of the caching infrastructure we've built or like things like page servers. So DMVs and extended events have been augmented and enhanced for you to look at those kind of type things, or you might see some special wait types that indicate you are being throttled from a log perspective, but because of the way our caching infrastructure works, you might see different types of wait types show up.
Thanks, Bob. You know, you really helped me and probably a lot of people understand how to troubleshoot some of these common performance scenarios. I hope you stay tuned for the next video where we dive into accelerating and tuning performance in Azure SQL.